And it's a time to gentlemen. I want to do a brand new song.
This is from a brand new musical, Tim Rice, Stuart Brace, from here to eternity.
It opens in September. If this song is anything to go by, it's going to be fantastic. See what you think.
Whatever I got, free will. So you don't get up from me.
I think it's going to be a huge hit. It sounds amazing.
And Sir Tim Rice is here this evening.
But I'm sorry to tell you, there are no more songs from musicals in this half of the show.
The second half of the show is all we're going to do.
And I want to pay my respects to the writers that I've worked with, who've influenced me, and have been a huge part of my career.
But this first half, I wanted to try and do something a bit different, and looking at songs from our new album, Both Sides Now.
Which has turned out to be one of our most successful albums.
You're late, but do come in.
You haven't missed much.
I could go back again if you want.
It's been one of our most successful.
Thank you to those of you who supported it.
If you haven't, don't worry. Don't worry. There's no pressure. They're for sale out there.
But I would love to think.
I would love to think, listening to some of these songs.
You might like them.
You might think you want to hear them again.
It's a different kind of an album.
It's a different kind of an album for me.
It's far more
introspective.
Quiet and thoughtful.
A lot of the songs were originally performed by women.
And I think it's fascinating to listen to songs written and performed by women, from a man's perspective.
Take this song, written by Mike Band.
But everyone knows it as a song.
By Katie Melua.
It's a beautiful.
Break my falling life.
It's
And I particularly love the work singer-songwriters.
One of my favourite female singer-songwriters.
Although she was in a group,
She was in the band Fleetwood Mac.
They're coming back to tour.
And I will kill to see them live.
They're magnificent.
But sadly, she doesn't sing anymore.
And I would have loved to have heard her sing.
She wrote it when all of the songs for Rumours were being written, produced.
You know, incredible time, creative time.
All their relationships were breaking apart, destroying each other, and yet creating some of the most extraordinary songs.
And this song in particular is one of my favourites.
She wrote it after she'd split up with a man who was working within the family.
He was their lighting designer.
And I just imagine what it must have been like night after night to hear these most beautiful words for him, so special.
Feel frozen, frozen, angel, angel, and ice cream cast in the air, feathers everywhere. I've looked at clouds that way. But now
they only block
the sun.
They rain, they snow on everyone. So many.
I would have done. Clouds got in my way.
I've looked at clouds from both sides now.
From up and down, still somehow.
Thank you. I love that song.
Thank you.
I love that song. written by Joni Mitchell, of course.
Written by Joni Mitchell, of course.
From an early age. I love all of her stuff. Everything that she's ever written, recorded, and that's a song that I've got older. As I've lived more, as I've loved more, as I've loved songs. And you find they take on deeper
meaning and bigger resonance.
They take on deeper meaning and
or
bigger resonance. Don't they
stay exactly the same.
Or
they stay exactly
and
the
they
same.
And they mean exactly what they meant when you
and
first
they mean
heard
exactly
them.
What they meant
like this when you first heard them. Like this.
I am not in love.
I am not in love.
But I'm open to persuasion.
But I'm
open to persuasion. East or west, east or west.
Where's the best?
Where's the best?
For romancing
with a friend, with a friend. I can smile,
but with a lover I can
throw my head.
With a lover I can
throw my head.
I can really laugh, really laugh.
Thank you. Thank you.
You took me dancing.
You took me dancing.
Across the floor. Across the floor.
Cheek to cheek.
Cheek to cheek.
With a lover I could really move.
With a lover I could really move.
Really, really, really dance.
Really dance.
I could really dance.
Really dance.
Really dance.
Really dance.
Really dance.
Really dance.
I could really, really dance.
Really move.
I could really, really move.
Really move.
Really move.
Now if I can
feel,
now if I can
feel the
sun in my eyes
and the rain
in my eyes
and the rain
why
on
can't
my
eyes,
why can't I
sing me another love song.
Sing me.
when it's black.
Take a little time to, take a little time to
hold yourself.
Take a little time to, take a little time around, to
feel around.
For it's gone, for it's gone. Won't let go, won't let go.
But you just keep on,
but you
falling
just keep
down.
On.
Remember
how you,
remember
how you
saved me now.
Of my wrong,
of my wrong.
If there's love, just feel it. If there's love,
there's
just
life
feel it.
To see.
There's life.
Don't
to
have
see.
To be alone.
Don't have
alone.
To be alone.
There's nothing I can't take.
You know what I was saying about a song?
You know what I was saying about
a different voice?
A song
and it's makes it have a different voice,
resonance, and a different feeling.
Makes it
to
have
it.
A different
great resonance and a different feeling to it.
Well, here's a great
was written by example
Randy Newman
for a movie.
Was written by Toy Story
Randy
two.
Newman,
in fact,
for a movie,
an Oscar for
Toy Story 2.
In fact,
and in
an Oscar for
the film.
It's the sort
and
of
the
subconscious
film,
voice.
It's
of
Jessie,
sort of
the little
subconscious voice,
cowgirl doll.
Of Jessie, the little
who is so loved,
cowgirl doll,
by the little girl
who
owns
is
her.
So loved.
But as the girl
by
grows
the little
older,
girl who
so
owns her,
she moves
as the
away
girl grows
from
older,
toys,
so
from her childish things.
She moves away from
Jessie
her
gets
toys
left behind.
From her childish
and it's
things.
So sad.
Jessie gets
and it's
left
so
behind. Poignant.
And it's so sad.
And it's so.
But if it's a real person.
But if it's a real person,
it has an even
more profound,
it has an even
feeling to it,
a more profound
feeling to it, I think.
When somebody loved me, when somebody
everything
loved me,
was beautiful,
everything was
every hour we spent together,
every hour
we spent
within
together.
My heart
lives
within my heart,
and when she was sad,
and when she
I was
sad
to cry,
I was there
to cry,
when she was happy,
and when
so
she
easy.
Was happy,
so easy.
If you're like me, and I hope you're not, because then you'd be really weird. If you're like me, and I hope you're not, because
the next song I'm
going to
sing,
when I heard it, The next song I'm going to sing.
Teenage years.
When I heard it,
first time
I
heard it, I went, and the first time I heard it,
that's the song I want at my funeral.
Yes,
that's the song I want at my funeral.
A little bit dramatic.
I did though.
I could.
A little bit dramatic.
I wanted people clinging on to each other.
I could picture it.
Didn't want anyone to be
brave. Clinging on to each other.
I just wanted.
Didn't want anyone to be brave.
And gnashing of teeth.
I just wanted weeping and wailing and gnashing of teeth
because I was carried out.
It's a country song, of course.
Honestly,
because I'm a sucker for those kinds of songs.
It's a country song, of course.
Because I'm a sucker for those kinds of songs.
They wear the heart on
the
sleeve.
And it was used in the
movie. But it got usurped.
The Bodyguard.
And it was used in the movie.
So I think I've given away
the Bodyguard.
And her rendition is extraordinary.
Absolutely.
Her rendition is
extraordinary.
Absolute simplicity
and the honesty of the original.
The simplicity
and the honesty of the original.
The lady who sang it and who wrote it.
And I got to meet
the lady who sang it and who wrote it.
Yeah.
Dolly Parton.
I know.
In Nashville.
Yeah.
6 degrees of separation.
I
know Dolly.
You know me.
6 degrees of separation.
I know Dolly.
That's how it
you
works
know me.
In showbiz.
You know Dolly.
So I met her. And
that's
you know
how it works.
They don't meet your idols. They can
so I met her, and you know they
sometimes
say, don't beat your idols, they can disappoint
not
you.
Not in the slightest.
She was flirting.
Not in the slightest.
She was flirting.
She was funny.
She was
so bright and
she was sincere.
She was amazing.
So bright.
She was dressed to the nines.
She was amazing.
She was about that
high.
She was
dressed to the nines.
She was about that high.
Everything I wanted.
Everything I wanted.
A perfect afternoon.
And I told her about my absolute love of this song.
And I told her about my
absolute love of this song.
Oh, Michael, I think you ought to record it.
And she said to me,
oh, Michael, I think you ought to record it.
But she said, my
best impression.
I ought to record it.
And I ought to do it how I hear it and how I feel it.
I ought to record it.
And I ought to do it how I hear it and how I feel it.
And that's what I've tried to do.
Just sincerely.
With this.
Possibly my favorite song of all time.
With this.
Possibly my favourite song of all time.
And happy, but above all this. But above all this, I wish you love.
Thank you.
All about the music.
We kicked off, of course,
the Circle of Life from the Lion King, written by Sir Tim Rice.
We kicked off, of course,
John. The Circle of Life from the Lion King.
We're going to have a few more of Tim's songs coming up.
But I wanted to look at.
We're going to have a few more of Tim's songs coming up.
He's the only American.
But I wanted to look at.
Be looking at
a writer,
an American writer.
Who
he's the only American writer we're going to be looking at.
Absolutely deserves
the title of genius.
He's one of the few writers who write both words and music. He's one of the few writers
he has been
who write both words
put on
and
a pedestal
music.
By me for so many years.
He
by
has
so
been
many people in this business
put on a pedestal
well.
By me for so many years.
By so
and
many
is,
people
course,
in this
Stephen
business
Sondheim.
As well. They think of him as one of the greatest.
And I asked him, as you do, I said, what song of his did he think
and
could
I
be
asked him, as you do,
for me to sing?
I said, what song of his did he think could be and one that he thought that
for me to sing?
He suggested this song. And
pay tribute to him.
And what it
and
does,
it
shows his brilliant, ironic, and slightly cynical use.
His
brilliant, his amazing,
ironic
ability with a melody.
Cynical use.
And it feels
his amazing,
like broad
ability with a melody.
And it feels
like broad ones to hold you too close. Someone to hold you.
Someone to hurt you.
In your chair and ruin your sleep. Sit in
make
your
chair you
and ruin your sleep.
Being
and make you aware. Being
someone to need you too much.
Someone to know you too much.
Need you too much.
Someone
to
pull you up short.
You too well.
Through hell.
Someone to
pull
you up
short
of
life
and give you
support
alive. Everybody's cup of tea, I know that.
But
he's
for
not,
me,
what everyone
one of
thinks
the greatest.
I've worked
the
with
writer
twice.
Of musicals for them.
First time
but for
1996
me,
one
in a show
the greatest.
Passion.
I've worked with him twice
in the West End.
First
and
time 1996
last year, in a show called Passion
in Sweeney Todd
in the West End. And then
oh, yeah.
last year,
I had the time
Todd.
Of my life.
I absolutely
oh, yeah.
did it. It had been a
I
lifetime
had the time
of of my lifelong ambition.
I absolutely did.
To be in Sweeney and to find myself of,
on that
a
stage opposite Saturn
extraordinary.
To find myself
a leading lady in a Mel
on that stage on a production that was extraordinary.
Just beyond belief.
A leading lady in a Mel
I don't know if you saw, but last Sunday we were very, very lucky
belief.
At the Olivier's.
I don't know if you saw, but last Sunday we were very, very lucky at the Olivier's.
No, I couldn't have been more thrilled.
Truthfully, being nominated and being part
no,
of
No, I couldn't have been more thrilled.
Truthfully, being nominated and being part is all that was necessary.
I practiced my losing face for hours.
You know what I mean? When you've got the camera,
I practiced
right
there,
my losing face
thinking,
for hours.
What am I supposed
you know
to
mean?
Do?
You've got the camera right there.
Name. And you're thinking, oh no, really, I'm thrilled
what am I supposed
for
to
you.
Do if they say someone else's name.
It's really hard.
Oh no, really,
it
I'm
was,
thrilled
it was magical,
for you.
Magical night.
And
it's really
kind
hard.
Of brought the
but
whole
it was
of
it was a magical,
magical
a
night.
Perfect conclusion.
And
kind
and
of
I
brought
want to
the
sing
whole
of
the
couple
Sweeney
of the songs from Sweeney
to
now.
Perfect.
And it's strange doing them
and
in this kind of
a couple of the songs.
Beautiful
from Sweeney
scenario.
And it's strange doing them in this.
Normally
kind of
when I sing them, there's blood shooting out of people's scenario
throats.
Because normally when I sing them, there's
blood
front row
shooting out of people's throats.
Better watch yourself. And looking at the front row. Better watch yourself.
Pretty women, fascinating. Pretty women, coffee. Dancing,
pretty women.
Our woman sing,
pretty women.
Our woman
sitting, pretty women.
The window,
or standing
against the window.
Something
in them cheats
the air.
Something in them cheats the air.
Pretty women,
silhouette. Stay with
pretty
you.
Women,
glancing,
stay
forever. Stay within you, breathing light.
Glancing,
pretty women,
pretty women.
So an earth song, I don't often do in concert. It's a big song. So an earth song, I don't often do
it
in
feels
concert.
Appropriate.
It's a big song.
I should be doing
but,
it.
But when I look around at what's
it
happening
feels appropriate
in the world, it's again written by Tim.
It's one of my favourite what's happened with his work
from Chess.
It's again written by
truly,
Tim.
Receive
it's
inspiration
from my favourite
of his work
from
song
Chess.
And I truly receive inspiration from a song like this.
There's a grief that can't be spoken. There's a pain that goes on.
Did you see the movie of Les Mis?
So,
did anyone see the Les Mis movie?
Did you
see the movie of Les Mis?
So, I was talking to Cameron McIntyre.
Did anyone see the Les Mis movie?
Oh, yeah.
And
brilliant. He told me, this is last
so,
year.
So, I was talking to Cameron McIntyre.
Claude Michel Schoenberg and Alan Boleil.
Oh, and he told me, this is
brand
last year,
he told me how Claude Michel Schoenberg and Alan Boleil, the character of Jean Valjean, had written a brand new song.
He sent me over a copy
and no one had heard of it.
For the movie,
from the character of Jean Valjean.
He sent me over a copy and no one had heard it at this point.
So I phoned Hugh Jackman, Claude Michel,
and I said I would like to record it on this new album.
And he said, my phone would be absolute pleasure
for you to
and I said I would love to record it on this new
album. And it would be lovely for me to come to the studio with you.
Absolute pleasure for you to
it's better than a Dolly Parton.
And it would be lovely for me to come to the studio with you.
Claude Michel came into the studio.
Better than a Dolly Parton.
For me, everything had turned full circle. The first time
Claude Michel came into the studio,
into a recording
for me, everything had turned
was to do the original London cast.
The first time
Claude Michel
I ever went into a recording studio,
friends,
was to do the original London cast
with Claude Michel.
And there we were, all these years later, as friends, working on a brand new song
nominated for an Oscar
for this movie.
And I think it absolutely contributes hugely.
The song is nominated for an Oscar.
Telling the story.
And I think
Jean Valjean.
I think they ought to think about including
huge
show
because it is telling the story.
This beautiful Jean Valjean.
I think they ought to think about including it in the show
between
because it
Jean Valjean's
this beautiful
little Cosette
and pure
relationship
between
Jean Valjean and the little Cosette.
Suddenly you're here. Suddenly
you're here.
Can
too anxious. Suddenly
stars work.
Came too
anxious. Yesterday I was alone. Today you walk beside. Yesterday I was alone.
Something
today you leave beside me.
Something not yet
healed, still unclean.
Has begun. Something not yet healed
has begun.
Suddenly the world seems a different place. Suddenly
the luck graceful
seems a different place.
Somehow as I was known, so much hope was held inside. How was I to know that so much hope was held inside?
Now we journey on.
What is the past is gone.
Now we journey on.
To know at last
that the past had come so fast.
How was I to know at last
that the past had come so fast?
Do you hear the angels sing?
important was that in their life? It was a turning point.
First time I'm in the West End.
Les Mis.
First time,
how
as I said, that I
was that in my life. It was
in a recording studio, and it
first time
in the eye
line, in a musical.
The movers,
first
and the
time,
shakers,
as I said,
and the
writers and the producers.
In a recording studio, and it kind of put me in the eye line.
That were being made,
the movers and the shakers
and
the writers and
the
producers.
It was such an exciting time.
The musicals,
and most crucial,
made in Britain,
put me in the eye line of one man who's probably had more influence
on my career. It was such an exciting time.
Certainly in the
most crucial
anybody else.
It put me in the eye line of one man who's probably had more influence on my career. Certainly in the theatre.
We've worked together for a long, long
time now.
Got to know him as well as anyone can. He's an extraordinary.
We've worked together for a long, long time.
He really is.
Got to know
he
him.
He can
as well as anyone
you.
Can. He's an extraordinary,
straight human being.
He really
drive
is.
Drive you up the wall.
He can inspire you.
But every time you work with him,
it is so exciting.
Drive you up.
Last
the wall.
Year. He told me that he'd written
every
a song.
Time you work with
and
him,
he'd written it
so
with Leslie Bricken.
So
last
he
sent
year,
me the song.
He told me
asked
that he'd
me if I'd like
song.
To record it.
And he'd written
and
it with Leslie Bricken.
What
so
I loved
he
about
sent
it
the song.
Is it's and asked me if I'd like
simplicity.
To record it.
And it's
what a
thrill
that was.
It, what I loved about it is
it sort of explains and explores
simplicity.
What all writers
and it's honesty.
It's striving for.
It sort of explains and explores
when they put pen
to paper. What all writers.
For us to
are striving for
what they're trying to do when they put pen to paper.
For if us to I could have just one wish of mine, if I could
reality.
Have just one wish
I
of mine, become would write
reality.
A fair song,
I would write
the perfect
just Andrew does. It takes a really, really memorable, simple melody, and it couple that with extraordinary lyrics and you have a great song.
Becomes really memorable.
Is it a perfect song? Has Andrew ever
couple
written
that with
the extraordinary
song
lyrics and you have
a great song
for the last section
is
of
it a perfect
this
song?
Show?
Has Andrew ever
to look at some of the shows and some of the
songs? I
thought
it would be interesting
that Andrew
last
given section of this show
years
to look at some of the shows and some of the songs that Andrew has given us.
forget these wide-eyed fears. No more talk, nothing can harm. Forget these wide-eyed fears. Nothing can harm me. Your fine words will warm. The daylight dry your tears.
And me, your friend,
with you beside.
The daylight dry your tears.
Don't write a letter when you want to. Don't write a letter.
Don't phone me
when you want to.
From a friend's apartment.
Don't phone me
from a friend's apartment.
I want to say
Thank you. Well, I have to sing this song. This is the first song of Andrews and Tim's that I ever sang.
Well, I have to sing this song.
And this is my school when I was 8 years old. Andrews and Tim's,
and I was cast as a hairy
that I was ever a part of. And I closed my school when I was 8 years old.
And I was cast as a hairy
curtain.
Has that 1987, when I was doing Phantom of the Opera,
but
he came to Andrew
me.
Ever written and told me about a new show that he was writing. And would I be interested
1987,
in when I was doing part of Phantom of the Opera,
he came to me.
I said, of told me about a new show that he was
rehearsal
writing.
Room at Her Majesty's
and
Theatre.
Would I be interested in being
and just the
being
two of
part
us
of that
workshop for
with
the piano?
I said, of course. He gave me a
went
lyric
into the rehearsal room
at Her Majesty's Theatre where Phantom was on.
And when he finished,
and just the two of us,
this is the song that's going to open
the
whole
piano.
Show.
What do you think?
And he gave me a lyric.
Now imagine how I felt. This
song.
Is the first time I
and
really
when he finished,
come into contact.
This is the song that's going to open the whole show.
What do you think?
He's been my idol.
Now imagine
years.
How I felt. This is
going
the first
to see
time
Tim and
really
Jesus
come into contact
and
why
with Andrew very
I wanted
closely.
To do what I'm doing.
And here I am asking.
He's been my idol.
Being asked
years.
By him.
What going to see some
Tim and Andrew.
So I just
Jesus
spoke
Christ
from my heart and I said,
why
I wanted to do what I'm doing.
Wonderful.
And here I am asking.
I
being asked
it's
by
magnificent.
Him. What have I ever got the chance
so I just
to sing
spoke
it.
From my heart
I would be
so
said,
proud.
I think it's wonderful. I think I've sung it now. It's magnificent. And if I ever got the chance to sing it, I would be so proud.
On stage in every concert I've ever
I think I've sung it now. I'm going to sing it again tonight.
Several thousand of times.
On stage.
It's how I'd like to finish this evening's concert.
And sing it again tonight.
The question.
Has he ever written a perfect song? It's how I'd like to finish this evening's concert. And the question.
Love.
Has he ever written the perfect song?
Love changes everything.
He wrote the perfect song.
Hands and faces. Love, earth and sky. Love changes everything. Love. Hands love changes everything. Earth and sky.
How you live and how you die.
Love changes everything.
Love.
How you make the summer fly.
How
or a night seem like
love.
A lifetime can make the summer fly.
Love
changes everything.
Now a lifetime
tremble.
Love changes everything in the world.
Now I'll ever tremble.
Yeah.
You can't stop the rhythm. You can't stop to feel. Emma! Would you like one more? Do you have the energy for one more?
Well, they're not lively.
Would you like one more? Do you have the energy for one more?
They're not lively. Love is like candy on a shelf.
Love is the sweetest thing you've ever seen.
Help yourself,
take a few.
Why, that's what I want
to help yourself.
The sweetest thing you've ever seen.
Help yourself,
take a few.
The sweetest thing till I'm free.
They're always told
to be
free.
Everyone in Hammersmith, I've had a blast.
Let's do it again, seriously.
Everything I do
Thank you. you say you love me. When you tend to go, you make up their story. The broken heart you brought to my life, the bitter tears of a shameful life. Why you lied to me at the day you came? And why did you give me unreal dreams of carrying tonight for my painful life? Maybe I'm happy in other world. Loneliness with me in the rest of my life. I would have fight to be for the justice. Don't underrate my power of mind. I would have fight and stand by my side. I would have fight and stand by my side. Saturday I've been alone, walking around in the silent sound, till the end of the blurry way. I felt some things blowing my ears. Lonely night, my heart was beating. I'm calling, calling in whisper.